I'm a complete foodie, guys. I don't know if anybody else is a foodie here. Yeah, we have foodies in the audience. Oh my God, yes. I am such a foodie, I get mad when I get full. I don't know if anybody else goes through that. The second I'm full, I'm like, no! I wanted dessert. I still have dessert, I have no shame. Because I've always lived by that philosophy, what if I get hit by a bus tomorrow? I don't want my last words to be, oh, I should have had a brownie. All the reports are like, she died so hungry. Her stomach was growling on the way to the morgue. So sad. That's what's gonna do me in. That's what makes it hard for me to diet, is my love of food. That and my confidence. It's got way too much confidence to diet. Because here's the thing, and let me explain it to you guys. I don't have, like, I feel like to lose weight, you gotta look at yourself and go, you know what? I'm getting a little big. Gotta lose some weight. My problem is, no matter how big or small that I get, I look at myself and I go, looking good, kid. You look amazing. Keep up the good work. And confidence will mess me. And don't get me wrong, I'm not cocky, I'm delusional. It's a big problem. It's an issue. I have what I like to call Latina confidence. Yeah. Latina confidence, guys. And you know we're confident. I know we have Latin people here. I know we have Latinos here. What's up, Latinos? Hey. Yeah. We have confidence for days, Latin women. People are always saying Latin women are so sexy. It's all in our confidence, guys. And you know we're confident because you've seen us in stuff we should not be wearing. We don't care what you mere mortals think of us. You think we can't hear you whispering? You guys are like, how far does spandex stretch? We're still running the tests. We'll let you know when we're done. I did find out recently that I had to lose weight. Here's how I found out. Because I went to one of those fancy gyms. Because let me explain my gym journey first, because I went to a few different gyms, okay? Here's what happened, okay. When you first go to a gym, you're not looking for a great gym, you're looking for a great deal, right? You're looking for a place that's not gonna charge you an arm and a leg. So I went to the most ghetto gym in the world. It didn't even have a name, it just said gym above a door. It was embarrassing. So I'm at this ghetto gym my first day, and I'm running on the treadmill. And if you've been to a gym, you already know the trainers come by and they try to sell you packages. That's their job. So I'm on the treadmill, and this tiny little paperweight of a woman walks up to my treadmill, and she's like, excuse me? Excuse me? I just wanted to alert you of some of your target areas. I'm like, no thanks, I'm good. You can just keep it moving. She's like, well, you probably want to work on your stomach because it's a little flabby and your thighs are kind of big. I know. I was like, ma'am, this is how people get shot in my neighborhood. For your own safety, I'm going to have to ask you to leave now. She just kept going. She's like, well, here's what I do. I don't eat any carbs after 9. I don't drink any juice after 11. I don't have any thoughts, feelings, or emotions after 12. I was like, oh my God, someone get her a hug and a cookie. What is wrong with your life? Now go away. She's like, no! That would have been so great if it happened. Yeah, but she just looked at me. I was like, did you just blow in my face? I was like, I gotta stop watching cartoons. That stuff does not work. So then I started going to an MMA gym, which I don't know if anybody's ever done any mixed martial arts, but it's dope, it's awesome, makes you feel awesome. It really does. And it was so cute because I'd be with my girlfriends and they'd be like, oh my God, I ran like 5 miles today. I'd be like, that's adorable, I'm a ninja. Continue running, I'll be fighting crime. I remember the coolest thing I ever saw at that gym was two guys having a conversation. And one guy walked up to the other guy and he goes, bro, you're getting fat. And the other guy went, true. That was the end of the conversation, guys. That was it. He accepted his weight gain with grace and moved on with his life. I could never do that with one of my girlfriends. I could never just walk up to one of my girlfriends and go, you're really getting fat, Cindy. She'd be like, I'm gonna go cut myself for an hour. You can just shake me out of the fetal position whenever you feel necessary. But I couldn't keep training there because I was on the road. So on the road, I went to this big fancy gym. And here's the story. I went to the gym and they sat me down for an assessment before they'd let me use any of their fancy equipment. So I sit down with the trainer and he starts saying stuff I've never heard before, like BMI charts and body fat percentages. And I was like, oh my God, I'm scientifically fat? I can't fight the power on this anymore. Not when there's a hypothesis involved. So he handed me a meal plan, to which I said, no, thank you. Because no, I'm not good at dieting anymore. I'm just not. I'm not. I start off with good intentions. I do. Like, I'll start off the day and I'll be like, good, you had an egg white omelet, Gina. Congratulations. You had a grapefruit as a snack. That's amazing. Time for some cheesecake. I think you deserve a reward. You did a bunch of good eating. Makes sense. Makes sense.